Hello, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Some of this data is captured within the complete onboarding session recording that's available online, but I wanted to take some time to cover one of the more complicated roles, the account owner role, in depth in this video. The account owner is the overall overseer of their particular account. They can add subscriptions for their account. Whenever they do add a subscription, they are, by default, the service administrator of that subscription. The service administrator is the person who actually has access inside of the subscription and leads the technical side of the project. So they have complete control over that subscription. They will be able to add services to it and add or delete other users to the subscription as well. Account owners can view usage data for their account. They can also view the actual charges related to that usage if the cost view is enabled by the enterprise administrator. The account owner will not have visibility of the overall monetary commitment or visibility into the spend and usage of other accounts unless they also have enterprise administrator rights. One important note, you can be both an enterprise administrator and an account owner, or the enterprise administrators, of course, can choose to delegate the account ownership service admin responsibilities to someone on their team. The account owner, if they like, can also edit the service administrator and assign someone from their team as the service administrator for any subscriptions they create. That being said, the account owner will lose access to the subscription if they do so. If the account owner would like to retain access to the subscription and also assign additional users to the subscription, they should add those users through role-based access control, either as an owner, contributor, a reader, or one of the service-specific roles that are available there. That process is captured within the complete onboarding video. For now, I'd like to focus on the enterprise portal and the account owner responsibilities within the enterprise portal. When an enterprise administrator logs into the enterprise portal and clicks into the account tab, this is what they'll see. They have the ability to see all of the accounts that are tied to their enrollment. They can, of course, use the drop-down box at the top left to quickly and easily filter down to a particular department. To add a new account, the enterprise administrator simply needs to select plus add account and fill in the information here. They can assign the account directly to an existing department or simply leave it unassigned for the time being. That is very quick and easy to update after the fact. They select the authentication type, name the account however they like, and assign an owner to the account by adding their email address here. You also have the option to optionally add a cost center for reporting purposes. Once the enterprise administrator selects Add, the account owner will be added into the list here on the left side of the page, and they will be added into a pending state. That account owner is sent a confirmation email, but they simply need to log into the enterprise portal, ea.azure.com, with the credentials that have been added here to activate their account. Once active, they will be able to add subscriptions to it. Now, let's say an account owner was to leave the company or move to a new role within the company, and that they no longer need account ownership within the enterprise portal, meaning they should no longer own or manage the subscriptions that are tied to their account. Luckily, it is relatively quick and easy to change ownership of subscriptions from one account owner to another account owner. Another use case for this feature would be if an account was originally added as a Microsoft account but needs to be converted to a work or school account. If you need to change the ownership of an account, whether it is because the original account owner has switched roles, left the company, or needs to transition from a Microsoft account to a work or school account, an enterprise administrator simply needs to access the account page. When they hover over an existing account, they'll notice four options that appear here. Now, the third option you'll notice is a Change Account Owner function. If an enterprise administrator gives this a click, they will be asked to select the source account. This is the old account where either the account owner left the company, changed roles, or the old Microsoft account that needs to be transitioned to the new work or school account. The destination account, of course, would be the new account owner or the new work account. Eligible destination accounts will be slightly highlighted. Once you select the destination account, you simply hit Next here, confirm the information, and select Submit at the bottom of the page. Now, once you do select submit, the change does not happen instantaneously. It takes 0 to 2 hours to load, and then after it loads, you'll notice the subscriptions have transferred from the source account to the new target account that you select. At that point, you can delete the old source account, which is now empty. There are a couple of things to note. 1. Subscriptions that also have marketplace services associated with them will not transfer using the tools provided here. In most cases, marketplace services will have to be canceled and repurchased after the subscription ownership has changed. 2. Only subscription transfers between two organizational IDs within the same tenant will preserve the existing service administrator and role-based access control rights. Essentially, moves within the same tenant will preserve any changes or additions that you have made to access within a particular subscription. If you have added co-owners, contributors, or readers and are transferring from one work or school account to another work or school account within the same tenant, those changes will be preserved. Those additional users will be preserved. Any other subscription transfers where there is a tenant change, whether that is from a Microsoft account to a work or school account, or from one work or school account to another work or school account in another tenant, these transfers will result in a loss of the existing service administrator, co-administrator, or role-based access changes additions that have been made. Those additional users that have been added will need to be updated by the owner of the destination account. That data is captured here within the fine print. We encourage you to review prior to submitting any changes. You can always engage with the support team for additional detail. The change account owner function transfers all subscriptions from the source account to the destination or target account that you select. You do also have the option of transferring individual subscriptions from one account owner to another. This would be used, for example, if subscriptions were created, but then after the fact, you decided that this subscription would technically roll up to another account owner who may be tied to another department within your enterprise portal. If that's the case, you'll notice the fourth option here is a transfer subscriptions option. This is essentially the same function, but instead of transferring all subscriptions from the source to the destination account, the system will allow you to pick up and choose individual subscriptions. Then you again select the target or destination account and select submit. Now, just like the change account owner function, this does not happen instantaneously. It takes up to 2 hours to load. Although there is a load time of about 2 hours with both of these options, there is no downtime or interruption of service. So you do not need to worry about shutting down and redeploying any services that you have deployed into production. You can also very quickly and easily edit the information you entered when creating the account by clicking the blue pen here. You notice you have the option to update the account name, the department to which the account is assigned, and the cost center. There is also an option here for dev test. If an account owner has dev test selected, this enables them to create enterprise dev test subscriptions, but it does not change any of their existing subscriptions. At the point of creating a new subscription, they can choose either Microsoft Azure Enterprise, the normal production-ready subscription, or EA Dev Test. Only active Visual Studio subscribers are authorized to use the Dev Test subscription. Also, there is no SLA guarantee for usage for services deployed within a Dev Test subscription. We certainly recommend deploying all production resources into a normal Microsoft Azure Enterprise subscription. Last thing to highlight here, enterprise administrators can also delete an account if needed by simply selecting the blue X here. If there are active subscriptions within this account, the active subscriptions need to be deleted prior to the account being deleted. Otherwise, the system will return an error when attempting to delete it here. Accounts that are deleted will remain in the portal in an inactive status so that they are always associated with historical usage and cost records. Inactive accounts can be reactivated by using the same process to add a new account. When re-added, they will have to log in to the EA portal to become active and entitled to once again create subscriptions. This concludes our overview of the account owner role. Thank you for watching.